In this video, we're going to import some data into Microsoft Access. In the US, because of campaign finance laws, when individuals donate to campaign for the House, the Senate, or the presidency, their information is recorded. I'm going to open Firefox. I'm going to go to the website for the Federal Elections Commission in the United States. We're going to take a look at one of these data sets because it's publicly available and it's a great opportunity for us to query the data set. So I'm going to go to the FEC website and I'm going to go to the section on the 2008 presidential elections. I'm going to look at New York State since that's the state I live in. It looks like it's the second largest state for campaign contributions, so it's going to be a nice rich data set. I actually want to look at the entire state. So instead of clicking on the map, I'm going to come over and I'm going to click on the campaign contributions for President Obama. Again, it's showing me a map, but this time the map just shows me the data sets for each zip code for President Obama. I'm going to click on the button that says Export New York Contributor Data. I'm going to download this file to my desktop. Now, I'm selecting President Obama, not for any particular political reasons. Instead, he is the largest single destination for campaign contributions, and by selecting a single candidate, we have one less variable in our analysis. My file is downloaded, so I'm going to take a look at my file. I'm going to right-click on my file and extract it to the desktop. When I open up the folder, I see a single text file that is roughly 50 megabytes in size, and as you can see, the data is all comma delimited. That means each field in the file is separated by a comma. The text fields have quotation marks denoting the text fields. This isn't very useful for me, so I'm going to close out of this text file. Now, because it is a comma delimited text file, I can rename the file, and I'm going to change the extension from .txt to .csv. Now it's a CSV document, and it's associated with Microsoft Excel. I'm going to double-click on this file to open it. Now, I'm not actually interested in bringing all this information into my database, so I'm going to be selective and delete some of this information. So what I've ended up with is fields for the contributor name, city, employer, occupation, the receipt amount, and the receipt date. I'm going to save my file as an Excel document. Compare this file size of my original file in text format, which is roughly 50 megabytes, to my Excel file, which is roughly 13 megabytes. That is because the Office 2007 formats are actually compressed, so you end up with much smaller files than you did with previous versions of Office. I'm going to open Microsoft Access. I'm going to create a blank database. I'm going to save it on my desktop, and I'm going to call this database ObamaBase. I'm going to click on OK. I'm going to click on Create, and it's opened a default blank table. I'm not going to use this table, so I'm going to close the table, and the table disappears. I'm going to go to the External Data tab, and I'm going to import an Excel document. I'm going to browse for my file, going to my desktop, and selecting my Excel file. I'm going to click on OK, importing the source data into a new table in the current database. It starts the Import Spreadsheet wizard. I'm going to keep the checkbox checked saying first row contains column headings because my first row does contain column headings. If I uncheck this, it would bring the column headings in as data, which I do not want. I'm going to click on that checkbox. And I'm going to go to the next screen. It's asking me for the data type for each field. At this point, if I chose not to import a field, I could select that. Notice that it's correctly identified this as a double numeric data type for the contribution amount. And the contribution receipt date has been correctly identified as a date time. So everything here looks good. If I wanted to at this point, I could create indexes. Those will also be created when I begin to analyze my tables. I'm going to click on Next. I'm going to let Access add my primary key for me. I'm going to click on Next. And I'm going to import it to a table. And that name is fine. So I'll go ahead and finish. It's going to take a period of time to import my data. Notice that I could have, at this point in time, checked to have the wizard analyze my table after importing the data, but I can also do this by going to the appropriate icon on the menu. My data has been imported. Notice that it took several minutes to import my data. If I wanted to repeat this process again, I could save the import steps. I'm not interested in doing that. I'm going to click on Close. Here's my new table containing the same data that was in my spreadsheet. I'm going to close out of this table. And I'm going to go to the Database Tools ribbon, and I'm going to click on Analyze Table. The Table Analyzer Wizard discussed the benefits of a relational database. For example, if you have a supplier listed multiple times in your database, there's a potential that the information could be misspelled, information is repeated. This is why we split data into multiple tables. I'm going to start the wizard, and I want to decide what fields go in what tables, and I'm going to click on Next. So it shows me a table here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to split the contributor table from the contribution table. I'm going to drag all the contributor information into its own table. Notice as I do this that the original table that it's creating has a primary key. As I create a new table, it creates a new primary key in the new table I create, plus it creates a one-to-many relationship to a foreign key that it creates in my original table. I'm going to click on Next. It's going to analyze my table for typos. At this point, if I wanted to, I would have the opportunity to apply corrections, but I'm going to ignore this and click on Next. It asks me if I want to create a query, but I will do this at a later time, and I will click on Finish. It's now beginning to split my data into multiple tables, generating the primary and foreign keys necessary. So now I have three tables in my database. I have my contributor table. I have table 1, which I have to close first before I can rename it, and then I will rename it as contribution, and I have my original table, which I no longer need, so I'm going to delete this table. If I go to the relationships view, I see my primary keys in each table, and I see the one-to-many relationship to the foreign key in the contribution table. If I look at the contributor table, I have the name, city, employer, occupation, and primary key for each contributor. I can click on the plus sign and expand it and see the individual contributions they've made. If I go to the contribution table, I see the primary key, the contribution amount, and the date of the contribution, and I see the foreign key to the contributor table. Access, when you perform the analyze table function, it creates the foreign keys as a lookup field. If I go into design view on the contribution table and look at the foreign key contributor ID, I can see the caption that says it's a lookup field. And in the lookup field, I can see the SQL query, which displays the lookup information instead of the foreign key. Because I'm used to dealing with enterprise relational databases such as Oracle, I generally dislike the lookup functionality, and I will usually delete the row source SQL information so that I actually see my foreign keys as numerals. Now, when I reopen the contribution table, I'm going to see foreign keys instead of seeing the name lookups. This is just a personal preference. If you look at the number of records, I have 317,000 records in the contribution table, and I have 76,000 records in the contributor table.